Snoop, pussycat.
Where have you been? I was getting worried about you.
What are you worried about? I was just out shopping.
Shopping for what?
Shopping for two tickets to see Crippled Nation tonight at the Coliseum.
Tonight?
Tonight.
We can't go tonight. We're supposed to go camping with Jason and Rachel and everybody. Don't you remember?
Well, can't we just go next weekend or something? It's not like I'm in the band and I can just push the shows back whenever I want.
No, we can't go next weekend. I had to ask off 3 weeks in advance to get this weekend off. Not to mention everybody else would have to change their schedules.
Well, then we could just go after the show.
After the show, you're going to be drunk and tired. You'll probably just pass out in the car.
Well, then why don't you fucking call Jason and everybody and tell them that we're going to have our own camping trip in my bedroom this weekend. We'll have way more fun doing that kind of stuff than out with the bugs and shit.
Damn it, Kevin, can't you think about anything besides sex or music for once? I can't call them because they're probably on their way here. We're supposed to leave in like 5 minutes. I mean, why do you think I've been sitting on your porch for the past hour? You were supposed to pick me up at 9 o'clock. By 9:45, I got worried, so I walked over here.
I'm sorry, dear, but
what?
I thought you'd like to go to the show with
me. No, you didn't. You thought you'd like to go to the show and that I'd just give in and go with you like I always do. Every time we make plans, it's for the stuff that you want to do. If we go see a movie, it's a movie that you pick. If we hang out with friends, it's with your friends. You know, I can't even remember the last time we did something that I suggested.
Well, I'm sorry. I didn't know you felt that way.
Where the hell have you been for the past 3 months? Don't you remember that we planned this trip to work things out?
Yeah, I do remember you saying something about that.
Jesus Christ, Kevin, has anything I've been saying even gotten through to you? I mean, have you heard one word that's even come out of my mouth? I know, I don't mean to blow up on you like this. I just want to make sure that I'm not fighting for something that you don't even want.
You're right, I'm sorry. I want to work this out. Sometimes I get a little fucking pig-headed, you know? I'm sorry. What's up, man?
Hey, what's up?
Did you get those tickets for later tonight?
Hey, Lauren.
Yeah.
I'll pay you later.
You son of a bitch. You son of a bitch. You know what? You can take your stupid concert tickets and your stupid excuses. And you know what? This whole fucking relationship. And shove it up your pig-headed ass.
Wait. Wait, Laura. Wait. 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 Did you say she wanted to stick something in my ass?
Laura, what's wrong?
Hey, where's Kevin? Should we go back?
Just go.
Hey, what's going on?
That fucking bastard.
Laura?
You went out and got fucking concert tickets for tonight.
Such a bastard.
I thought this was your fix the relationship retreat.
Yeah, so did I. I guess Kevin had other plans.
Damn, that's pretty low.
You know, it's not even the worst part. The other ticket wasn't even for me. It's for his dumbass fucking roommate.
That fucker. Hey, if you want, I can turn around right now and I'll beat his ass.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just want to get away from him and have some fun.
Bastard.
Don't worry. We're going to have a great time this weekend.
Here. This will help you have some fun.
No, I don't really. Oh, fuck it.
Yeah.
Yay!
All right. That's it. At least a little.
If you need a little extra pick-me-up, just let me know.
No, I think that'll do me for now. So where'd you get this van? What happened to the Firebird?
Do you like it? I got it from my cousin last week for about $400. It ain't the prettiest thing in the world and don't always like to start the first time, but it's got sentimental value. I can't tell you how many chicks have taken a ride in the back of this love machine, if you know
oh
what I mean.
God.
What was that for? Babe, that was a long time ago. You know I ain't been with anybody since I met you?
Yeah, that helps a lot.
So, what's up with this hippie jam band music, man? You turn all deadheads on us now or something?
Hell no. The fucking tape player's broke. My cousin threw a fish tape in there about 3 years ago and we haven't been able to get the damn thing out since.
Yeah.
Hell, I wish I could get it out. I'd like to hear some Megadeth right about now.
Damn, and I still wanted to hear Symphony of Destruction.
Really?
No, not really.
You just don't know how to appreciate a good band like Megadeth.
Yeah, I can say a little bit before my time.
They're still around.
Dude, I thought one of the guys hurt his arm, they broke up.
Man, fuck that. They've been putting albums out since 85, and they ain't gonna stop putting out albums until Dave's fucking arm falls off, and even after that, they'll probably just find some other guy to play guitar for them.
Your undying devotion to washed up hair bands is truly amazing. Pathetic, but amazing.
Whatever, dude. It's your loss.
Alright, so how long until we get there?
About 3 hours, give or take a piss break or two. But I'm only stopping once, so if y'all gotta go then, you better make it then. Got it?
Yeah. All right.
Good.
Fucking made it. How does one pit stop turn into six? Can you tell me that, a great math wizard?
Screw you, man. I had to stop once to piss, once to get gas, and four times for beef jerky.
Oh, Christ. You're not sleeping with me tonight, then.
We'll see. You'll get lonely in the middle of the night and come calling for me.
Oh, don't worry. If I can't find you, I'll just look in the back of your van.
Would you please? Never mind.
Why don't we just get our stuff unpacked?
Great idea. Why don't you tell Douche for Brains to hand me my stuff?
I am Douche.
Look, I'll get it. In fact, why don't you ladies just chill out and we'll get all of it unpacked. We'll meet back here.
Alright.
Hey, I want to go swimming.
I don't think they'll let us though, since this is a park.
Damn.
We can always just go lay out by the lake. You hate the sun. I'll just hang out and chat.
Damn, I forgot my sunblock.
Don't worry. I've got some.
Ready? I guess so.
Bye, Douche.
Fuck you.
So how long have you and Jason been together?
7 months, 13 days.
Damn, someone's counting.
What, the argument?
Do you think y'all actually break up over this?
No. We have our fights here and there, but other than that, everything's almost perfect. I knew he was the one the first time we met.
Aww, really?
Yeah. It was at a flea market. He was browsing through a bunch of records some guy was selling when he came across this rare Metallica bootleg called Creeping Live. Well, he reached for it the exact same time this other guy did, and Jason told him to back off, but for like 30 seconds they locked eyes, just waiting for the other one to make a move. They each had one hand on the record and the other one waiting to strike. So the other guy started to make a move and Jason just popped him one square in the nose. It was great. Blood went everywhere.
Oh my God.
Fell to the floor. Jason bit down a bit and flipped him over to make sure it was okay other than the broken nose. And when he looked up, our eyes met and he said, "Oh, sorry you had to see that, but I couldn't let a shit like that buy a treasure like this." I just smiled at him and said, "Well, actually, he was buying it for me for our 6 month anniversary present." Yeah. He was pretty ashamed and surprised there for a couple seconds. I just walked over to him, put my arm around him, said, "Don't worry, he's an ass anyway." We've been together ever since.
Oh my God. That's definitely the most unique meeting I've ever heard.
Isn't it romantic?
Sure, if you're Jerry Springer.
What?
Nothing.
What are you looking at?
There's a guy staring at us over in the bushes.
Hey, asshole! Why don't you come over here so you can get a better look?
Oh shit, I think he just insulted a cop.
Hello, ladies. Sorry if I frightened you. Actually, I'm not a police officer. I'm the ranger in charge of this park.
Just because you've got a badge doesn't give you the right to be a peeping Tom.
No, ma'am. I'm not trying to be a voyeur. I was watching you. but not for reasons that you may think.
What the hell are you talking about?
Well, I'm on the lookout for, let's say, aggressive fish.
Aggressive fish?
That's right.
You mean like with scales and shit?
Yes.
Why don't you try looking in the lake?
Normally I would. However, this is the Asian snakehead fish. What they do is they swim around the lake, eating all the fish they see, and all the fish are gone. They get out, and they walk to another.
They walk to another, like a person on two legs.
Well, maybe not quite like that. More like they crawl around.
And you've actually seen these things around?
No, not yet. They're quite clever. They tend to stay out of sight. However, there's been such a drastic drop in the fish population of this lake, I believe that's the only cause.
How many are there?
Yeah, it's hard to say. If I had to take a guess, 5, 6, maybe more.
And you think that they're walking around out here somewhere?
It's highly possible. Like I said, there are no fish left in this lake. They're probably out trying to find another source of water, another source of food. Luckily for me, there's not another lake for miles, so I think I've got a good shot at finding them.
Why does this feel like a bad episode of Scooby Theory?
So, you ladies plan on being here long?
A couple of days.
Well, if you need anything, and I mean anything, you just let me know. My cabin's right up there. I'm usually around.
Thanks. But I'm sure the two hunks of male strength that we brought with us will be able to protect us against any walking fish.
Well, I see. Well, if there is anything you need, and if you see any of those fish around, you let me know. Y'all have a good day now.
All right.
Will do. Oh, Christ. What a creep. I bet he's gonna go jerk off to the image of us sunbathing.
I don't know. I thought he was pretty cute.
Damn, girl, I thought you had finally lost your mind.
No, I'm not the one out stalking killer fish.
Oh, I'm into that, sister. Oh, you guys haven't seen, like, a toilet or a porta potty or anything around here, have you?
I doubt they have any.
If they did, I don't think you'd want to use them.
Really. Damn, I have got to piss like a racehorse. I'm gonna go find some bushes or something. I'll be back.
Charming.
Yeah. Well, what she lacks in inhibition, she makes up for with expression.
I love it when you talk dirty to me. So how have you been? I'm worried about you. You didn't say much the whole way here.
I'm all right. I'll be all right. Yeah. See, right now, I'm just angry. I just can't believe that he threw away years worth of time together for some stupid rock shit.
I'm sorry.
Don't be. I mean, I should have seen it coming anyway. It's not exactly like the last 3 months have been a walk in the park. You know, I don't think he's listened to a thing I've said for a really long time. I'd suggest something, and he agreed to do it, and then, like, today, he canceled at the last minute.
Well, why'd you stay with him so long, then?
I don't know. I guess I thought we could work things out. Now I'm not even really sure why I wanted to. He was always going out of town, check out some new bar, some new band. I mean, even when he was in town, he'd rather hang out with his fat, hairy friends instead of me. I mean, if I was lucky, I could count on him stumbling into my apartment at 3 a.m. drunk and looking for sex.
God, yeah.
Well, he'd make it to my bed, take off his shirt, then pass out. Sometimes afterwards, I'd just curl up next to him and cry.
Damn, Laura, you're totally right to dump his ass. He didn't deserve a beautiful, smart, sexy girl like you.
Thanks. I know, it's just so hard being alone.
Don't worry. As long as I'm around, she'll never be alone.
Ow! Damn it! I'm stuck! I'm stuck in a bush over here. Will y'all come help me?
I'll do it. I brought her along.
I'll be on the lookout for aggressive killer fish.
Hang on, I'm coming! Hey Laura, your phone's ringing.
Get it for me.
Hello?
Hey.
Evan?
Look, before you say anything, I just want to say I'm sorry for being such a dick earlier. You were completely right. As usual, I was completely wrong.
Wait, you...
I know what I did today, okay? I put myself before your needs, and I realize that now. I want to make it up to you. I want to try and make it up to you, at least. So I want to come over there tonight. I want to bring you flowers and chocolate and anything else you want, okay? I don't want to lose you.
Yeah, well, maybe you should have thought about that sooner.
Laura, I'm sorry. I swear that I am. I'm a moron, an idiot, and I'm a bastard. And I'm going to make it up to you. I promise. No more going out every night with the guys. No more ignoring you. No more stumbling in drunk off my ass at 3 a.m. And also, listen, I promise... From now on, every time we, you know, make love or whatever, I promise I'll wait on you before I
you know.
Laura?
Wait, no. Don't bother coming down here.
Laura, I can't hear you. Your phone's dying.
Hello? Damn battery.
Oh, hey! What took you guys so long?
Man, I've spent the last few minutes picking every fucking thorn in that forest out of my ass.
Yeah, well, I guess next time you'll look before you drop your pants.
Oh, fuck you. I guess maybe if I had of, I wouldn't be with you know who.
And speaking of you know who, maybe we should go see what they're up to.
Yeah, go see if Mr. Sensitive has grown a brain yet. Somehow I doubt it.
So you think you and Rachel be all right?
Oh yeah, we fight probably 2 days out of the week.
Why are you still together then?
Man, don't you know that fighting feeds the flame of passion?
What?
Haven't you ever been with a woman?
Yeah, but not one I fight with twice a week.
Oh, well, I guess it has its disadvantages too. Nah, this fight ain't nothing though. There was this one time, right when we first got together, I thought I was going to do a sin for sure.
Damn, she didn't break up with you for that?
Well, it was dark and I couldn't tell them apart. Well, it's getting dark. I don't know where the hell the girls are at. I'm gonna go look for them, all right?
All right. Here, I'm gonna grab another beer. I'll go with you.
Okay.
Ow! Fuck. Dude, what the hell happened?
The fucking bee stung me.
Damn, what's with the girly scream? I thought you lost a toe or something.
That hurt like hell.
I think you'll live.
Just don't tell the chicks that I scream like a girl.
Don't worry, he won't have to.
Damn it.
We were just about to come after you three.
Why? To protect us from the evil killer fish?
Yeah.
What?
It's a long story.
Yeah, a little too long for your attention span, dear.
Thanks, dear.
Besides, you can't even stand a little bee sting. How the hell are you going to protect three damsels in distress against aggressive water life?
What the fuck is all this talk about fish anyway? Is this some kind of pussy joke or something?
Oh, no. Exactly the way I left it.
So you ladies want a beer or something?
Yeah, I'm thinking we should save those for later. We can make a fire, get trashed, and tell ghost stories.
Great idea. I just hope the man of steel here doesn't get too scared. He left his security blanket at home.
Shut the hell up. It's not a security blanket. It's the official Judas Priest bandana from the British Steel Tour. Oh, fuck all of you.
I hope we weren't too hard on him.
Don't worry. He'll go soak for about 15 minutes and then a squirrel or something will catch his attention and he'll forget why he was sitting there all by himself.
All right, well, if we're going to get a fire going, we need to go get the wood now. Getting dark, and I'm not walking through the dark woods all night, alright? Let's go.
Yeah, we gotta watch out for snakes.
Hey, why don't you let somebody else try?
I told you 5 times, I can do this. I used to do this all the time in Boy Scouts.
Yeah, but that was like 10 years ago and 1,000 brain cells ago.
Fine. You know what? Fuck it. You're gonna keep running your mouth while you tell a story or something.
All right. Do you know the one about Dr. Leary's monster?
You mean Timothy Leary, the LSD guy?
Yep, that's the one. All he does is drop acid and fuck Hicktown whores in the back of his shitty van with his cousin. But I guess you already know that one.
God damn it!
Hey, can we just take a minute out and have a good time? You know any other good ghost stories?
No, sorry. I don't really know any good ghost stories.
Fine, look, Jason, you start a story. When you stop, I'll pick up and we'll just go down until Rachel finishes, alright?
Alright. If it's a dark and stormy night,
On Christmas Eve.
Stormy? Must have been a blizzard.
Anyway, it was in this big old sorority house. This chick was there by herself, except for this other chick that was passed out drunk upstairs. Everybody else went out to some parties and to go shopping and stuff. And she's sitting by the fire, reading a magazine, when all of a sudden, the phone rings.
The girl puts the magazine down slowly and looks at the phone terrified. She's been receiving harassing phone calls for the past couple of days. As she walks towards the ringing phone, she hopes not to hear that terrible voice on the other end. Slowly, she picks up the phone and puts it to her ear. She closes her eyes. "Hello," she says. For a few seconds, all she hears is silence. Then, the dreaded voice. "Do you hear me? Do you hear what I'm doing to your friend? Listen to her scream." She hears muffled screams over the phone. Her heart is pounding. Her blood is racing. "Take that, you bitch," the voice raves on. She can hear a woman being raped over the phone. The woman screams and screams, and then, suddenly, the receiver is quiet.
She slams down the phone and paces furiously. She's waiting for the police to call her back. The phone rings. She's startled. She walks over to the phone, picks it up. "Hello," she whispers. "Ma'am, this is the police. The call is coming from inside the house. The killer is inside the house."
The girl drops the receiver, her eyes fixed upon a dark figure slowly coming down the stairs. It's a tall, thin, blood-covered man. As he walks toward her, lifting his knife higher and higher into the air, he stares down at her and whispers in his maniacal voice, "First, I'm going to kill you, and then I'm going to rape you, just like I did your friend upstairs." With each step forward, she grows more and more certain of her fate, knowing that her body is going to be violated, first with the blade, and then by the killer's manhood. And as both entered her simultaneously, her last breath of air rose and became a blood-curdled, dying scream.
Well, did he come or not?
Jesus, Jason. There's some things you just don't talk about.
All right, well, we forgot the beers. Anybody else want one? I'm going to get one.
I'm about to hit the sack.
Oh, me too.
Yeah, I'm kind of tired of today.
All right, see y'all in the morning.
Good night. Bye.
Oh, where do you think you're going?
To bed.
Not in here, you're not.
The fuck are you talking about?
What do you mean, what the fuck am I talking about? After all the shit you have pulled today, no, there is no way in hell I am sleeping next to you.
Fine, you know what? I'm gonna take my fucking sleeping bag. I'm gonna go out in the dark woods. I hope some bear comes along and eats me in my sleep just to make you feel bad.
Fine, don't come crawling back here when you hear an owl or something and get too scared to be by yourself.
Don't worry. Don't you worry one fucking bit.
Don't say anywhere in here that it's wrong.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know you were in here.
Oh, no, it's okay. I was just getting ready for bed.
All right, well, I'll see you tomorrow.
Where are you going?
All the beds are taken. I'm just going to go sleep on the couch.
What are you talking about? There's plenty of room in this great big bed for the both of us.
Are you sure?
Of course.
All right, as long as you're sure you don't mind.
Listen, I'm going to go brush my teeth. You just make yourself comfortable here in the bed. And I'll be back in a few minutes.
Thanks. You're a really good friend.
Get bitten by a snake or put his back on top of an anthill or some stupid shit. God damn it.
Dear Kevin, here's to our new start and the end of all of our problems. I love you with all my heart, Laura.
Best.
Why the hell are you here?
Because I obviously have something you don't. A conscience.
Why are you ragging on me so much?
You really don't have a clue, do you?
I guess not.
Do you really think that I want to hear about all the girls that you fucked before me? You think I'm impressed or something?
Is that what this is about? I didn't think you'd still be bitching about all those chicks I banged before we were together. I didn't think it'd matter now that I'm with you.
No, you didn't think. You didn't think at all, did you? You know why you don't ever hear me talk about the guys that I slept with before? Because I know that you don't want to hear it.
Go ahead.
What?
Go ahead and tell me the guys that you fucked before.
Oh, hell no. I am not about to start all this.
All right. Just tell me some of the most fucked up places you've done it, and we'll call it even.
No, because then you'll get jealous and we'll just fight for the rest of the weekend.
Look, I'm tired. I want to go to sleep. Can't do that if we're fighting. Just tell me some of the most fucked up places you've done it and we'll be done. And then we can go on with the rest of our lives.
All right, hang on.
Well, hurry up. I don't have all night.
Jesus, okay. How about the back of Rick Darris' car?
Who hasn't?
With his father.
What else?
In an elevator. In a dentist's office.
Uh-huh.
A pet store?
Uh-huh.
A Walmart.
Uh-huh.
A baseball game.
Mm-hmm.
The Talladega Speedway.
Uh-huh.
And with a total stranger at a Guns N' Roses show.
GNR?
Yeah. It was the Illusions Tour.
Tell me.
Want me to tell you about it? All right. Well, I was rocking out with my friend Kelly when she fucking had to go to the bathroom and right in the middle of Welcome to the Jungle. Oh, I was so pissed. The good friend that I was, I walked with her. I remember it was totally crowded. She was taking so damn long, I just wanted to go in after her, but I decided to wait for our seats instead. Then when I turned to leave, I saw this really hot guy near the men's room. He was kind of tall, with his hair shaved at the sides, but it was long in the middle. He had both nostrils pierced and a tattoo that said, Cliff Burton, rest in peace. Oh, he was so hot. I was just trying to play it cool. We exchanged a couple of glances and everything was going okay. Until they started playing November Rain.
Long or short version?
It was long. But anyway, you know what that song does to me. And I just couldn't help it anymore. So I just walk right over to him, grabbed him by his arm, and threw him into the men's room with me on top. There had to have been like 100 people in there, and I just rode him like a camouflaged Jeep. With every beat of the song, I just grinded.
Yeah.
And grinded.
Yeah.
And grinded?
Yeah. Baby, daddy wants to fuck. Yeah.
Oh, wait.
What?
You're not mad anymore?
No, are you?
No.
Good.
Wait.
What?
Do you have any condoms?
Yeah, right here in my wallet.
Good.
Wait.
What?
You know what to say, right?
Yeah, now get down there.
Yeah.
Oh! Oh, Axel! Oh! Axel! Oh!
Sorry I took so long. Laura? Where the hell'd you go?
Oh, fuck yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Damn. Damn, nice. Oh, good.
Hey, come in. What's up?
Nothing. I was just looking for Laura.
No, I haven't seen her anywhere.
Oh, well, I'll let you get back to whatever you're doing.
I was just about to go for a walk.
Yeah, I see.
No, if I see Laura, I'll tell her you're looking for her.
Yeah, I'd appreciate it.
Okay.
What are you doing here all by yourself? I've been looking for you. I'm sorry, I couldn't sleep.
You all right? You've been crying. Kevin, right?
I know. My life's gonna be so much better without him. I just don't know why I miss him so much.
It's gonna be okay. I know it doesn't seem like it now, but this is for the best. He treated you like shit. He never listened to you. He never waited for you to come, or your suggestions. He always just plowed ahead with everyone to do with or without you.
Yeah, you're right.
Of course I'm right. You were right to dump his punk ass. Right now he's probably at that stupid concert looking at other chicks, not even thinking about you.
What?
I mean, until he wakes up tomorrow and realizes he's lost the best thing he's ever had.
I guess.
Don't worry. Time will see it's the best thing that ever happened to us. You.
Yeah, how about that?
Not bad, baby. Not bad at all.
Not bad? Shit. I think I threw my back out.
Well?
Well, what?
Is that it?
Is what it?
How about an encore?
Damn, woman. I just gave you sweet loving 2 minutes ago.
Oh, come on. I got a lot more energy left.
All right. Just let me get some JD and I'll be ready to go.
Okay. Are there any more condoms?
No.
Damn, I'm glad I brought some. Here's my purse. Oh, shit. I left it at the cabin. Did you go get it for me?
I can't.
Why not?
I gotta save my strength for round 2.
Fine. I'll go get it. Just don't drink too much. Or else you'll be passed out before I get back.
Okay. Just hurry up before the sun sets, if you know what I mean.
Oh, God. I can't believe I'd date you sometime. I'll be back.
Yeah.
Sorry, I was looking for Laura. Have you seen her anywhere? I heard you're in here.
No, not since earlier.
Well, if you see her, will you tell her Jordan's looking for her?
Yeah, I'll do that. You'll excuse me, I have certain business to attend to.
Okay, sorry to interrupt.
That's it. That's... Mom, no!
Come on, big boy.
I'm not sleeping. Oh, no. No sleeping here. I'm wide awake. Baby. I didn't know you liked toes. We're gonna have to fight like this more often. Baby. I know you said you'd never do this, but since you're trying new things, come on, just a little bit of tongue, you know where, please, yeah, baby, I feel so good, just like that, oh, I love the pain. Ow! Hey, wait! That kind of hurts.
Jason, where are you? Oh, damn it. Can't see a damn thing out here. Jason, Christ, he's passed out by now. Jason? Are you asleep? Come on, big boy. Rachel's ready for another guitar lesson. Jason. Oh, come on. If you don't wake up, I'll have to start without you. Jason?
Jordan, have you ever been in love?
Yeah, I have.
Really? Because I've never really seen you with anyone here romantically since we've met.
No, I suppose you haven't.
Not that I'm one to talk. God, I'm always bouncing from one idiot to another. You know, out of all the guys I've dated, it feels like I've just been with one person. All of them have been bad in their own way. Kevin's the selfish type. Richard was a redneck. Vince had a serious lack of ambition.
What about that guy in the 10th grade with the blue braces and the really bad acne? What was wrong with him?
Yeah, he seemed nice enough until I found a pair of my underwear in his house. So you take him home to jerk off?
Gross.
Yeah, tell me about it.
That's what I like about guys. They're so big and hairy and stink and jerk off the Olsen twins.
Yeah, guys can be pretty bad. That's what I was talking about, you know? Even though all those guys were bad in their own way, it's like they've all blended together in my mind. So it's like I've been in this one really horrible relationship for most of my life. Do you know what I mean?
Not exactly.
I'm sorry. I keep blabbing about my own problems. I haven't let anybody else talk about themselves since we left.
That's all right. God knows you got reason enough to be upset.
It's all for the best, right?
There you go.
So tell me about the person you're in love with.
Well, it's not much to tell, really. We've never talked about it. Never found the right time or way to bring it up.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to pry.
That's all right. It's bound to come out eventually.
It must be awful not to be able to tell someone that you love them.
Yes, it is.
It must be awful not to be able to wrap your arms around them.
Yeah.
To kiss them on the cheek.
Not to be able to fall asleep in their arms.
To hold their face close to your heart.
To caress their long flowing hair in the moonlight.
To feel the soft touch of your lips. Did you kiss each other gently?
To feel their naked body lying next to your body.
It must be absolutely terrible.
What the hell?
What? I didn't hear anything.
It sounded like Rachel. Let's go.
Shit. Rachel, are you out here?
Probably just some fucked up role-playing thing they do before they have sex.
Thanks for the image.
Look, there's the tent. Go see if they're in there.
No thanks. You probably haven't walked on anybody today, so it's your turn.
Alright, but I swear, if I see Jason naked, I am out of here. Hey, you guys okay in here? Rachel?
Oh my god.
What?
Oh my god.
Days, I'm gonna get all you imported bastards.
What the hell?
Harry, one of our friends is dead and two others are missing.
Dead? What happened?
It was one of those fish.
Fish? A snakehead fish?
Yeah, we found our friend and it burst out of her chest.
They've eaten all the fish. They're eating people? That's impossible.
I swear to you, we've gotta hurry.
Well, if that's true, then I've gotta get every last one of those before anyone else gets hurt. You know how to use one of
yeah.
these things? Good. Then let's go.
Get back! Damn, that thing's fast. You have a car?
Yeah.
Look, my suggestion is you get in that car, find your friend, and get the hell out of here.
What about you?
Don't worry about me. I gotta get that one before it gets away.
Good luck.
Thanks, and hey, remember, if you see one of those things, shoot to kill.
Josh, thank God.
Where you been?
Jason and Rachel are dead.
What are you talking about?
Look, I don't have time to explain. We gotta find the van.
What about Jordan?
She's
and
on her way. Kevin, what about Kevin?
When I went looking for you over by the van, I saw his car over there.
Oh my god. Are you sure?
I'm positive.
All right, look, we'll split up and look for him, okay? But stay within eyesight. I can't lose you too.
Okay. Bastard. Clever girl. Kevin! 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 I don't see him anywhere.
Josh, get away from the lake! Ah! Oh my god!
Oh, fuck. Oh, god.
Are you okay?
No, my leg's all fucked up.
God, we gotta find something to stop the bleeding.
Oh, fuck. What the hell was that thing? Ow. Fuck.
Like, that'll work if I can get you to a hospital. Can you walk?
I can try.
Alright, come on. Damn it, son of a bitch, open! Damn, George, stay with me! Come on. Find the keys. Where are the keys? Where are the keys? Oh God. Kevin has the keys. Josh, I gotta go find the keys, okay? Keep the doors shut and locked until you see us coming, okay? Josh, stay awake. Motherfucker. Damn it. He's in Kevin's car. Oh shit, look, that's not all. Let's get the fuck out of here. Josh, get the door ready. Josh, open the door. Josh, I'm sorry, hold it back. Josh. We did it! We fucking did it! We made it out! We're gonna have to make it to a hospital fast. What does that sign say? Next town, 35 miles? What's that light on the dashboard? Oh, shit.
The trip that you're playing, the night has a strange little twist in between. I know you came here to fix things with your man. Now we're running from aggressive fish. Take my hand and we'll see the other side. Oh, we'll fly all the way home. We need each other if we're gonna make it out alive. As long as I'm here, you'll never be alone. Cause my love can beat the snakehead fish. Cause my love can beat the snakehead fish. Happiness is around the bend of the bend. Forget about all of your friends who just died. lies to you, it's love I send. It's my day, it's my love. Can beat the snakehead fish. It's my love. Can beat the snakehead fish.
That's alright, I just want to get as far away from him as I can. Just have some fun.
That's what I'm saying.
Damn it!
We just gotta come after you three. Where are y'all going? I'm sorry.
Yeah. Oh, fuck. Yeah, I like that. Do it tighter. Hey, Jordan. Thank you. Hey, thanks a lot.
That's so
rude. 10-2. Let's do a 10-2.
You started laughing.
Turn around.
I wouldn't get it up.
You almost had it.
God!
Don't do your legs like that.
She slams down the phone.
Fuck, she says.
Man, this is the police. The phone is coming.
The phone is inside your house. It's next to your face.
Her last breath of air rose from her lungs and became a blood curdled, dying
sigh.
Well, then we can just go after the show.
After the show, you're gonna be drunk and tired. You'll probably just pass out in the car. Sir? I'm mad.
You should be.
I'm mad. You know, I just wanna make sure that I'm not trying to save something that you don't even want.
I'm supposed to say.
Speechless.
No.
Wait. Wait, what the fuck did you say? You're not sticking anything in my ass.
They're probably on their way here. We're supposed to leave in like 5 minutes. Why do you think I've been sitting on your porch for the past half hour? I knew it would come to me.
I like it though, it's surprising.
You son of a bitch. You son of a bitch. You son of a bitch. Stop laughing! No, we can't go next weekend, Kevin. I mean, we just can't.
Call everybody up and tell them that we're gonna have our own little camping trip in my bedroom this weekend. We're gonna have way more fun being horny and stuff than going out with the bugs and shit.
What have we here?
That's gay as fuck.
What do we have here?
Me and the friend.
This friend's rocking.
Hop right in.
Come on up.
Oh.
Oh. Hey, what's up?
Well, Vince is up. That's okay.
Come in. Oh. Hey, what's up?
I was just jerking it.
Yeah.
If that's true, then we've got to get every one of those things before they get everybody. You know how to use one of these things?
Yeah.
Good. Let's go.
Man, you don't know? Fighting feeds the flame of passion.
What?
Haven't you ever been with a woman?
Well, yeah, but not one I fight with twice. I can't read this part. We need to switch places. I'm sorry.
Alright, have you heard the one about Dr. Leary's monster?
You mean Timothy Leary, the LSD guy?
Yes, that's the one. All the monster does is drop acid and fuck hick town whores in the back of his van with a shitty cousin.
What's new, pussycat?
Where have you been? I was getting worried about you.
Shopping for two tickets to see Crippled Nation tonight at the Coliseum.
We can't go tonight. We're supposed to go to camping with Jason and Rachel and everybody. Don't you remember? Staring at us over the bushes.
Well, I'm on the lookout for, let's say, aggressive fish. This is the Asian snakehead fish. What they do is they swim around the lake, eating all the fish they see. All the fish are gone. They get out and they walk to another.
That they're walking around out here somewhere?
Remember, if you see one of those things, shoot to kill.
Snakehead fish, Cause love can beat the snakehead fish. Cause love.